In spite of what we go through on a daily basis. Yes, things are difficult. Yes, things, times are hard. But you be encouraged. Hang in there. The Bible says, take unto you the whole armor of God, that when difficult times come, you'll be able to stand. Stand up and bless him. Stand up and praise him. In spite of the way you feel. I got to get out of here. I got to go. Woo!
Well, good morning and welcome to worship at Scarborough Salvation Army. We're delighted that you can be with us today. Well, we've already been encouraged to stand up and declare the faithfulness of God. What a week. A week in which we have seen the declaration of a president-elect and the announcement of a medical breakthrough which may lead us towards the end of a worldwide health crisis. We indeed have much to stand up and bless the Lord for today. And so we invite you to join with us this morning as we sing King of Kings, Majesty.
King of Kings, King of Kings, King of Kings, Majesty, God of Heaven, living in King of Kings, gentle Savior.
Before you go, before you go, before you go, If you have your scriptures with you this morning, and if you'd like to turn to your Bible just now, as Lindsay Barker is going to bring us a reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Following on from this, Joan Fletcher is going to lead us in a time of prayer.
Let's look into God's word today. In our reading, the Apostle Paul shares some of his own personal struggles and how his personal weakness becomes a platform for God's power to shine through him. 2 Corinthians 12 verses 7 to 10 says, "Therefore, in order to keep me from becoming conceited, I was given a thorn in my flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. Three times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me, but he said to me, 'My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness.' Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong."
Would you like to pray? Lord, we are reminded that you must increase and I must decrease. Please come and take complete possession of my soul. Transform my mind and heart, guide my will, emotions and desires, and allow me to become a holy instrument of your divine life. Remind me that it is only as I acknowledge my own weakness that your strength and power can be seen in my life. We pray with the poet, "All to Jesus I surrender. Lord, I give myself to thee. Fill me with thy love and power. Let thy blessing rest on me." And our desire is that as we too surrender our lives, we will encounter the power of your Holy Spirit for the glory of Jesus. Amen.
It would perhaps be true to say that we live in a world that praises strength and power and control. And yet today we're going to look at how different our lives could be if we're able to hand over that control back to God. Image is so important to us, isn't it? And so often we're bound by the perception of how others may see us. And so this morning we invite you to encounter a real freedom in Christ as we allow him to remove the shackles from our feet and as he invites us to dance. I love the quote which says, "Sing like no one is listening, love like you've never been hurt, dance like nobody's watching, and live like it's heaven on earth." Well, this morning there is nobody watching in your living rooms or whichever room you're watching this on, so please feel free to get up and dance as we sing this great song of praise.
Much pressure fell on me. I thought I was gonna lose my mind.
Well, this morning we just really want to recognise that we are in a really tough time. For some of you, this will again bring fears of loneliness and isolation. And we want to pray God's blessing on you as we journey through this time of lockdown together. Please keep in touch. And if anyone within our church, our core, our leadership team, or ourselves as church leaders can help, please do make contact by telephone or email if there are ways in which we can support you. That brings us to a time in our meeting where we offer you an opportunity for very practical support for our fellowship. In a moment, we will bring up our QA code, which allows you to make an offering to God through the gift application. Simply take out your mobile phone or device, and as a QA code comes, scan that device by your camera, and this will allow you to make a donation to the work of the Salvation Army here in Scarborough. We pray you'll be blessed as we share in these moments of worship and giving together.
As far back as I can remember, I was going to church, not really thinking for myself. I was just going through the motions, what my family told me I should do. I went because they went. It was just a routine we had every single week. And around middle school, I started getting into things like cursing, pornography, and things like that that I knew was wrong, but I continued to do it anyway. It continued into high school. I got into things like drinking and sex, drugs, just my life had completely fallen apart. I would feel good during the time that it was going on, and then I'd go to church and I'd regret everything that I would do that week and then just go back to do the same things over and over again. And I would put a face on in church so I would be a different person around church people, but when I would get back into school around my friends, I would act like I was. I always knew that God was in control. It was kind of just in the back of my mind. I tried to ignore it. So there were definitely times where my friends would ask me to go do something that I knew was wrong. And God would even be like, hey, look, you shouldn't be doing this. And I would kind of shove it off to the side, be like, I'm going to do what I want. It wasn't until my junior year in high school that I had an experience that really woke me up for good. Around this time, I'd started having sex with a girl, and we ended up getting caught by the police doing something, and my parents found out. And the disappointment that I could see from my parents really hurt me, and it definitely made me feel like I needed to change my ways. I really wanted to get more into church, and just seeing how happy all of those people were versus all the regret and pain that I was constantly going through, it definitely seemed like a much more enjoyable life to be closer to God like those people and to get plugged in with those people. I decided that I want to get rid of all those things that were hindering me from my relationship with God. Drinking and cursing and things like that, drugs, just I felt like it wasn't giving me any satisfaction, so I kind of distanced myself from those kinds of things. It was a gradual process, but eventually all of those things stopped. I felt like me being in control was what I wanted and what was best for me. Since surrendering to God's authority, I feel like I don't need as much from this world as I do from God, that He can provide everything for me and that He can satisfy the desires of my life.
Well, we hope you were blessed and challenged by that video. But we now invite you to join us further in sung worship as our worship team invite you to sing This Is Amazing Grace.
Keep on.
Well, for many years, Angela and I were very privileged to own a property in Cyprus. It really was a gift from God, and in particular, the communal swimming pool became the focus for our family. Holidays were great, and our daughters and I and ourselves spent hours playing in the water. It was a great place to meet friends, invite guests, and we spent hours swimming, having competitions, playing water polo, playing It's a Knockout, you name it, we played it in the sea, in the pool. What a great time we had. But during that period, one of the things I also remember was the fact that we had what was affectionately known as the pool police. Yes, you heard me right, the pool police. You see, there were two residents who took endless delight in policing the pool. Woe betide if you would dare to enter the pool without first showering. Woe betide if you would enter the pool after 8 o'clock at night. And certainly woe betide if you would dare to sit around the pool and do some topless bathing. You will appreciate I didn't often do that. They lived on the complex and they had control over the complex. God forbid that that would ever happen to us in church. After all, we don't have an organist within the Salvation Army, so surely we're safe. But you know, I do reflect on times where we want to hold control instead of relinquishing. I was really challenged by one Salvation Army centre who decided they wanted to run the Alpha course, but they decided they didn't want the Holy Spirit as part of that encounter, and so they omitted the Holy Spirit weekend. No surprise that that church fellowship no longer exists today. And so what is the central issue? The central issue is very much the challenge that control is something that so easily we succumb to. I guess in the past week, we've experienced internationally one of the worst examples that when those who are in power refuse to relinquish control, we encounter the damage that this created in the wave which follows. You see, in the life of faith, religious control is the counterfeit of self-control. For self-control is the fruit of the Spirit. In fact, Paul reminds us in his letter to the Corinthians, "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And we who with unveiled faces all reflect the Lord's glory are being transformed into his likeness with ever-increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit." Did you catch that? Paul is desperate for us to understand that when we are filled with the Spirit of the Lord, our shackles are gone. We can be released from the control of sin and released to encounter the joy of freedom. Sadly, all too often there are rocks, even boulders, in the river of our life which limit the flow of God's grace and freedom in our life. And I've been really challenged over the last couple of weeks that perhaps one of those rocks is the rock of control. Never could we have imagined, going back to this time of year, that the year ahead would be totally destroyed. The things which were foundational within our lives, within our core, would be stripped away for many months to come. Our building with its sacred spots, its icons, its remembrances, our comfort zone, our fellowship, our weekly fix of jelly babies as we share in tea and coffee and cake, our uniform, and the many activities which constitute part of church life together, but also with it, control over our style and brand. And so I'm challenged to ask whether God is using the devastation of COVID to impose a time out. You see, for each of us, control has been suspended. We no longer have control over our freedom, over our finances, our employment. We no longer have control over our leisure facilities, the sport which we watch, and certainly we have limited control on the effect of a virus which is ravishing the world. And so I'm challenged to ask, what is it that God requires of me in this time? What does he require of his church? For in these days our props are gone. We come back to God almost naked, relying upon his provision. The church now has to be turned outwards instead of inwards, as we're now challenged in how we serve a world which is facing poverty in its many facets. And so I'm challenged to ask what God requires of me. What does he require of his church? For in these days our props are gone. We come almost naked before God, relying on his provision. The church is turned outwards as we now are challenged with how to serve a world facing poverty. Yet I'm actually challenged also that maybe the church is also facing poverty too. I'm constantly disturbed to ask how many within our community have discovered the love of God as a result of our ministry, and how many are discovering the freedom in Christ. Maybe God is forcing a time upon us, a time out, when we have to reevaluate our priorities and once again discover that if we are to encounter the growth of the kingdom, we first need to surrender order and control back to the freedom of God's Spirit. George Matheson wrote incredible words all the way back in 1868. He wrote, "Make me a captive, Lord, and then I shall be free. Force me to render up my sword, and I shall conquer be. I sink in life's alarms, when by myself I stand. Imprison me within thine arms, and strong shall be my hand." It's very interesting that at a time where William and Catherine Booth were fighting for the freedom of salvation in the early Christian mission, George Matheson had also discovered the upside-down world of God's kingdom and its values. Look at the incredible paradoxes that we find. He reminds us that as we become captives, so too we become free. As we submit, so do we become conquerors. But also, as we sink under the weight of the world, so do we encounter the strength of God in the arms of the Saviour. I believe that the Apostle Paul understood this when he declares in 2 Corinthians 12:9, "My grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness, so that Christ's power may rest on me." And there we have that true nugget of gold. It is that if we are to encounter the power of Christ in our lives, it's not because we're brilliant, not because we're great orators, strategists, politicians, or even visionaries. It's the acknowledgement that through our weakness, God's power flows out and our own control and power subsides. And so I'm challenged to ask this morning, are there boulders in the river of our life which need to be removed to allow you and I to encounter true freedom in Christ? Where do we need to relinquish control to allow the outpouring of God's Holy Spirit in our life, in our church and in our community? As we draw our worship to a conclusion, Matt Woods is going to allow us time for reflection as he sings, "I have seen the glory of the Lord, God eternal, in this time draws near." God bless you. Enjoy this time and allow God's Holy Spirit to speak to you as we listen to these words.
I wait. have seen the glory of the Lord, and in his presence my heart is stirred. God eternal in this time draws near, the King of heaven. Despite its power, it's empty of your worth. The ground may shake and fires roar, but without the presence of the Lord of Lords, then a voice quiet and clear speaks to me and draws my spirit near. I have seen the glory of the Lord. My soul was lifted, my hope restored. God eternal in this time draws near, the King of heaven is here. With lightning, thunder, shouts and cries, and a million angels covering the skies, creation lifts its voice in prayer.
Well, we thank you for joining with us this morning. We really hope that you've been blessed and challenged by God's word and enjoying sharing in time of worship together. We'd like to leave a benediction with you this morning. The benediction says, may God's love surround you and God's spirit guide you. May God whisper cheer over you and God's peace calm you. May God's shield protect you and God's wisdom arm you. May God reveal his power and strength in your weakness. May you know his overwhelming love and presence wherever he might lead you. We pray God's blessing with you as you go this week, and how fitting that we end our worship this morning by singing, I'll go in the strength. God bless you.